by trolling through it. Still to come, should you take the 0% interest rate credit card? Well, not without reading the fine print. The head of DebtSmart.com is going to explain in just a minute. Well, it seems like a great idea. You sign up for a new credit card with a zero interest rate and transfer all of your current debt to that new card. 6 months later, your rate jumps to, 29%, and suddenly the deal does not seem so good. Well, our next guest says one problem might be that you didn't read the fine print closely enough. Scott Bilker is the author of many books on credit, including Talk Your Way Out of Credit Card Debt. Great to have you back on the show.
Thanks, Ali. Thanks for having me.
This is your title is fantastic because in many, many ways, you actually can have that conversation. You're a big advocate of get on the phone and talk to the credit card company and say, hey, there's lots of credit card companies out there. I'm not going to do business with you unless you can make a better deal. And I would say what's anecdotally 50, 60% of the time you might get somewhere?
Yeah, I find that about even 80% of the time when you prepare to actually contact the banks, you're definitely going to get somewhere because there's so many offers available right now. You just have to open your mailbox to see how much competition there is in the market. So finding a great deal is just a matter of a little bit of work.
All right, let's talk a little bit first of all about these zero interest rate offers. We all get them, 0 or 1 or 2%. Right. They all look fantastic. Sometimes they're for life, for a long time.
Yes.
There are some offers where they've said 3.9% transfer balance over and you can hang on to that. There's usually a fee of some sort associated with transferring a balance in. So even if it's zero, you're paying something.
That's right.
Usually.
Yeah, usually when these offers come, the most important thing is going to be the actual APR itself.
Right.
And that can vary too, and that's going to be adjusted by those other fees that you were talking about. And there are many other things to consider when you get that fee, when you get that offer too. For example, how long you have to take advantage of that offer and how long that offer lasts, like you were mentioning. Many times there are 3.9%. which is fixed until you're done paying off the balance, and that's a great deal. But, you know, 0% deals for a year are also great deals depending on those fees.
Let's talk a little about who this is good for. I was talking to a guy who actually worked here who said this is all he does. He transfers balances between credit cards. He reads the fine print, never misses the point at which the higher interest kicks in. Somehow he manages this, and it's fairly active. It's a lot of work, but he does it. If you're not prepared to be a little bit active about it, you could really get burned.
Yeah, you definitely can, because if you wait too long, you're going to be paying it whatever the new rate is when the deal ends.
And that's sometimes no deal at all.
Right, sometimes.
That's actually, in many cases, much higher than what a logical alternative might be, an installment loan or a bank loan of some sort of consolidation loan.
Right, but it's definitely important to stay on top of it. I mean, if you're late a couple times, the penalty rates will kick in, and rates can rise as high as like 29.99%. But if you keep the 0% going, it's worth the effort, because say you save $1,000 in the year on your debt by transferring your balances, and it only took you 10 hours worth of work.
Yeah.
You're saving $100 an hour.
You're getting paid well for doing that.
Very well.
There are a number of things that can get you. It's not just hanging on to this thing past the date. It's if you miss a payment, if you don't make a minimum payment. Sometimes your agreement will tell you that any default shoots your rate up.
Right. Usually every offer. It used to be that wasn't the case, but now I would just assume that every offer is going to have that condition.
So write in your book or your palm or whatever you use what to do. Now, here's the other one that gets you. I've done this a couple times where I buy an appliance or an electronic from one of these stores that says don't pay till whatever. And you don't pay. You can pay minimum payments every month. At some point, even though you're paying your minimum payments, you've got to have paid everything or all of the interest.
Right, yes. That's another one of those fine print issues. Yeah. You got to look for that stipulation that says if it's not paid off in full under this deal by this date, they're going to charge you retroactively for all the interest.
Right, and it's not like there's a big yellow sticker on the invoice that comes to you and says this is your last month to pay this, or you are going to pay all that interest for the 24 months you didn't pay.
Right, yeah, they're not going to tell you in advance.
Yeah, so you really, I mean, if you can do some great things in keeping track of these low interest deals. I mean, they're there for the taking if you can handle it.
Yeah, they're worth tracking. I track all my low rate credit offers, and I have so many credit card accounts that I have about half of them with low rate offers all the time. In fact, I haven't had a rate higher than 0% for like 3 years now. That's how many low rate offers and 0% offers I get.
Now, some of these offers are for anything. Some of them are for balance transfers, to transfer balance from somewhere else. Some of them are only for purchases or only for trade. It's not that anything you do on a credit card is going to qualify you for that rate.
Right, and there's other conditions too, like they'll have different breakdowns and interest rates depending on how much you take. For example, it'll say if you only use $1,000, it's 6.9. If you use $2,000, it's 5.99. If you use the whole thing, it's 1.99. So that's another part of the fine print you need to carefully analyze.
Let's talk about the transfer fees. Let's talk about the annual fees, things like that.
Sure.
If you're transferring a nice big balance and you're getting 0% for 6 months or a year, it might be worth it, but what should you be conscious of?
That transfer fee. Usually the case is that it's 3% of the balance, $5 minimum or $50 maximum.
Right.
That's fair. But you can always get a lot of them that have no transfer fees. What you have to really be careful of are the ones that have no ceiling on the transfer fee, like 4% with no ceiling. Because if you transfer like $10,000, that's a $400 transfer fee. And now we're talking about 0%. If it's a six-month deal and you're charged a one-time 4% fee, it's annualized, it's 8%. So it's not really zero, it'll cost you 8%.
You know what happened to me? I got one of these things. And it was a lifetime. 3.9% or something like that. And I used it at one point. I didn't need it for a lifetime. I just needed to use it. And then one day I needed to use a credit card for something, and I had this credit card on me. So I bought something, and I think it was a $50 purchase. That $50 purchase is never coming off. I'm paying regular interest rates at that $50 level because the fine print said that your payments are applied to the low interest part of the deal.
Yes.
So if you go make a purchase and it comes in at a higher credit, higher rate, I'm stuck paying whatever interest rate on that one purchase. Yeah, until I'm paid off.
Your low rate actually will lock in the higher rate, and that's something to be very cautious of, and that's one of those fine print details. For example, say you had a $10,000 credit limit and you had $5,000 in purchases at, say, 12%.
Yeah.
You got an offer for 0% on your remaining balance. If you do that transfer and you owe $10,000, it'll be at that split rate, some at 0, some at 12, and when you make your payments, it's all going to go to the 0%. Now, the way to get around this is to take that money. You can't write them a check for the $5,000, because that's always, you can't pay them off with their check. Take their check, deposit it in your bank, then write them a check for $5,000 from your account. Now you'll owe that $5,000 at zero. Then you'll still have $5,000 available at zero that you can use to pay off other debts. And now you've got it all back down to zero.
Back to the point that you started with, you actually kind of have to do a little homework here.
Yes.
And figure it out. If you do your homework, you could come out way ahead of the game. You know, one of the things that people often say here, because we take stock calls on these shows and we talk about investments, and we talk about really struggling hard to get, you know, 10% on your investments on an average basis.
Right.
Well, if you're paying 18% on interest, every dollar saved there is better than most investments that you can have.
Oh, exactly.
Like for most people, if you carry debt, managing your debt, spending your time, as you said, 10 hours managing your debt, is really, in many cases, better than spending 100 hours trying to trade stocks.
Exactly, because you're saving so much money in interest.
Yeah.
If you're saving, you know, $1,000, like I said before, you know, it's $100 per hour. I don't know where you're going to get a side job that's going to pay that. And it could even be more.
Scott, it's always a pleasure talking to you. Thank you for being with us.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me, Ali.
Scott Bilker is the author of Talk Your Way Out of Credit Card Debt. He's also the founder of DebtSmart.com. Well, still to come, it is getting to be that time of year for holiday shopping. We'll tell you why you may want to think twice before maxing out your credit cards. And later, your calls and credit calls and emails.